Today we head to Marugan Koi Farm to search for new koi for the pond. Marugan is one of the top koi farms in Singapore. It is located in Lim Chu Kang. Marugan breeds their own koi. At the same time, they also import koi from famous Japanese farms such as Dainichi, Isa, and Momotaro. Let's take a closer look at the koi that are bred by Marugan. These are the parent kois from Japanese farms, such as Dainichi and Marusei. As genes play a very important part in breeding, the parents are chosen for their size, body shape, colors, patterns, as well as the farms that they were from. The farm is divided into two sections. The lower part houses local bred kois, whereas the upper part houses both local bred kois as well as Japanese imported kois. Let's take a closer look at some Marugan bred koi. They have a good selection of showas for you to choose from.
This is quite unique.
Also the color.
If they are very bright when they are young, they are more female. If they are very light when they are young, then it's female.
It's very sweet and strong vibrant color. It is like that.
This group of showa shared the same parents. The parents are from Dainichi and Marusei.
Twenty-nine. 26.
Oh, okay. Oh, I thought they were
20
here.
They seem
very small.
There are also Tanjo Showas. They are considered to be more difficult to breed than the normal Showa. This Tanjo Showa is essentially a Showa with only red markings on the head. It shared the same parents as the Showas shown before this. These Tanjo Showas are highly sought after, especially if their Tanjos are rounder, as it resembles the Japanese flag. We also decided to check out the imported Japanese koi. A pair of vibrant color showa from Genjiro Koi Farm caught our eyes, so we decided to bowl them for a closer look. This Genjiro showa is just over 2 years old, or what is known as a Nisai in the koi world. It currently measures about 48 cm and has potential to grow above 65 cm in years to come. In the end, we decided to pick one imported Japanese koi and one local bred koi to bring home. We quarantined the koi in the farm for a week to make sure that they are healthy before bringing them home. The koi are packed in bags that are filled with air that can last them for at least half a day. On final inspection before we pack them. After a short journey, the koi finally arrived home. Before putting the koi in, we will acclimatize them first. First, we leave them in the bag in the pond for about 30 minutes to 1 hour to make sure that the water temperature is the same. Next, we will scoop small amounts of water from the pond to the bag. This will help the fish to adjust to the water chemistries of their new home after a few rounds of adding. Once it is done, it is time to introduce them to the rest of the gang. show us an amazing koi. Just look at the before and after. We hope you enjoy this little tour of Marugan Koi Farm. Do give us a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.